Bullet charts are gauges with extended options. They can be used to visualize and compare performance of a measure to a target value and to a qualitative scale. Bullet charts let you compare and measure performance with more detailed information than a normal gauge. This is helpful when comparing performance according to a target or a simple performance rating. For example, you can show how sales relate to a target value or simply in terms of poor, good, and excellent performance. To start, we will drag and drop a bullet chart onto the sheet. Add a measure, for example, the sum of sales. You can add a target value, which is displayed as a marker line. You can define a fixed value or use a measure with target values. To add performance ranges, set Use Segments under the measure to On. You need to add limits to the ranges you want to use for showing indicators with Add Limit. You can set a limit value in three ways: by using the slider, by typing a value in the text box, or by setting an expression that returns the limit value. You can add more than one performance range, and then you can change the colors of the ranges. Now we are going to create another bullet chart, but this time we will also add a dimension to it. As you can see, the bullet chart is now displaying a different gauge for the dimension value. As before, define the measure, the target value, and the range. Add more limits to the ranges. Now you can modify the appearance of the chart. In this case, we are going to change the bar colors and the target color. As you can see, you have a bullet chart with a gauge for each product. In the third example, we are going to create a bullet chart with multiple measures with independent axes. First, we add the sum of quantity, and then we are going to apply a target to it. As a second measure, we add the sum of sales. This time, we are going to set the target, and then we are going to add the performance range. We will add the sum of cost of sales as the third measure. In this case, we set a target, and then we are going to set two limits in the performance range. Then we are going to customize the color of the ranges. We are going to add another measure to calculate the number of suppliers. This time, we don't set any target, but we add two ranges using an expression to calculate the range value. When done, use the gradient option in both ranges. As you can see, each measure has been set in a different way. By changing the colors of the bars and the target, the change will be applied to all the measures. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.